Welcome back to Madison Square Garden in New York, where the brave men of the braided bungalows are brought to you by Tim Hortons Triple Chocolate Baked Goods. It's irresistibly chocolatey. Henrik Lundqvist against the Leafs, 3-2-0 lifetime with a 3.79 goals against average. Andrew Raycroft against the Rangers, 4-1-1, 2.28.
Well, have you ever seen this guy play any better than he's playing right now after coming off the concussion? I haven't. He has been great. And last night, the big line and the victory over Pittsburgh were made up by these three guys. But four players for the Rangers can all hurt you. And you better be careful, or they will.
Len Healy in between the benches. Downey is there in the walkway on the way out. The referees tonight, Brad Watson of Regina and Kelly Sutherland of Victoria, with Steve Barton and Jean Morin, are the linesmen. And this hockey broadcast is available on TSN HD, Canada's sports leader in high definition. Last time Watson and Sutherland officiated a Leaf game was the game in New Jersey when Thomas Cabrera was staple to the boards in that controversial hit. So we are underway and glad you're along with us here in Madison Square Garden. The implications of this game have been well documented for both of these teams. Kavina steps up and with a shot, juggled, the rebound in front of the net is knocked back of the net. Roosevelt being chased by Ponikarovsky, drops it back, and Nylander gets it onto the near wing. Here is Jagr, a long right wing pass for Nylander, working in over the line, drops it back, and the shot went wide of the goal. Jagr trying to play it into the corner, picked off by Kavina, outlet to Cabrera and on to Sundin. Returns the favor. Here's Cabrera winding and shooting! That went off a stick and almost handcuffed Lundqvist. Round back of the net, far side, Roosevelt trying to get to it as Steen is taken off his feet, and a penalty is coming here for interference to the Rangers.
Jagr's going to get it. He interfered with the forechecker. And the Leafs will go to the first power play of the game. And here it is right here. He steps into Steen, and Steen had a bit of an angle on Roosevelt, who had the puck, but couldn't get to him because of the interference.
48 seconds into it, and the Leafs on the power play, where they are 3 of 19 in their last five games.
And the Rangers' penalty kill has been effective, too. Five goals against in the last 50 times short.
Against the Rangers this year, the Leafs have scored five power play goals in 17 opportunities. Into the corner it goes. Here is Wellwood at the side of the net, looking for Tucker in front, couldn't find him. Pohl works the far board. John Pohl back to the point, and a shot by McCabe goes wide of the net. Wellwood and Pohl trying to come away with a loose puck. Left in the corner for Wellwood. Wellwood loses it, and now the Rangers with a chance to clear, get it in front of the goal, and a quick turn by Jed Ortmeier sends it down the ice.
This rink's got real fast boards when the puck is shot against the yellow border at the bottom. The goalies have to be ready for it to come off those boards in a hurry.
Cabrera to the line. Tucker had been forced over the blue line, and it's offside.
The Toronto Maple Leafs, two big plays they have on their power play, and the Rangers are very well aware of it. And you watch Brian McCabe at the point. Everybody knows he's got the big bomb. So Holvig, right away, 41, Ortmeier goes right out to him. I'm going to take that shot away, and he'll do that all night. And the other play they love to use is the down low play, either with Pohl or with Wellwood. And it's that creative play across the crease to Tucker.
Cabrera back in his own zone. Now here is McCabe skating at the center. He'll fire it in as it bounces around back of the net. Roosevelt played it up on the wing, but Sundin arrives on the play in front of the net. They score! Ponikarovsky set up by Sundin, and the Leafs have taken a 1-0 lead.
It all started with a good shoot-in by Brian McCabe. And if you're going to shoot it in on the power play, make sure that puck's going somewhere where your guy can get there at least at the same time the opposition does. And nobody in front of the net on Ponikarovsky.
21st of the year for Ponikarovsky.
Well, the one big thing about this building, guys, it's the old stanchion. So anytime pucks are shot in the glass, goalies know you stay in the net because you're going to look like a fool at times if the puck hits the stanchion the wrong way and goes to the empty net. So it's exactly what happened there. In the glass, McKay puts it, and Lundqvist has no chance but to stay in the net.
Seventh power play goal of the year for Ponikarovsky. And the Leafs have a 1-0 lead. As Ponikarovsky equals his goal output from a year ago. Shanahan dropping it back, but it bounds out into the center ice area, and the Rangers will go back to regroup. 1-0 Toronto early here in the first period. Paul Mara twisting back, gets the pass ahead from Thomas Poke as it goes into the Leaf zone. Raycroft couldn't settle it down. Koliakovo is jammed to the boards. Now into the corner, Avery trying to get it back to the net, and does. Avery cycles it along the boards now for Jed Ortmeier. He is taken out of the play, and the Leafs get it up on the wing, and out at center ice it comes. A hit by Avery took stage into the ice. Back of the goal goes Girardi. Girardi carries it to center. Working up on the left wing, trying to shoot it in. That struck Ryan Callahan in the back, and now it's played into the Toronto zone. White, with the Rangers changing on the go, stands back of the net and starts out for Toronto. White ahead for Wellwood. Wellwood trying to play it in over the line. Goes to Tuck for his shot. Blocking arm save, but a huge rebound to Hal Gill. Gill back of the net for Kelger didn't work, and it's pushed to center ice where White will gather it up at the Toronto blue line. Wellwood tipping for Tucker. Across the line, offside was Kelger in early on the left wing.
Well, one addition to this Ranger lineup that everybody is applauding. This is the warm-up. And the warm-ups are always full of entertainment. Avery trash-talking Tucker. It starts well before the game starts. And he backs it up during the game as well as Matt Stajan gets introduced to one of the newest Rangers. Thank you very much. When Avery's in the lineup, the club is 15-5-5. So they needed some grit, and they got it, Harry.
104th hit. And you may hate him as you play against him, but you're going to fall in love with him. He plays for you.
Shot by Perro goes off a stick and up into the screen and out of play. Holly Horton is standing by with an update. Kabina plays it back in the net. Hole against the boards. Double team back there. Perro hoping for a loose puck and finds it. Perro back of the goal. Goes back into the crowd. Lost the puck. Still free. And Cole has it now at the side. And back to the point it goes. Tavare over to Kabina. Kabina will send it around the dasher into the area back of the goal. The Rangers cut it off. And it's played by Thomas Poke out at center ice. Tavare got a bad change. Here's a chance for Battaglia. And Lundqvist got down low to take that five-hole chance away from Bates Battaglia on a bad change by the Rangers.
Well, one reason why the Rangers are threatening to make the playoffs and do something when they get in is this guy Lindquist. In his last 13 starts, 9-1-2 with a .946 save percentage and a .171 goals against average. He is one of the best at his position.
Against the Leafs this year, though, a .509 goals against average.
The 9-2 loss.
That helped. Yeah, you're right.
He gave up that late touchdown. That's what killed his goals against him.
Near side for Malik. He drops it back, and the Rangers organize as the Leafs on a 1-0 lead. Jagr brings it to the line and in. Dropping it back, it goes now with a chance by his Bister, and he set it wide. Nylander in the far boards to Jagr. Jagr trying to curl out, leaves it for Nylander. Nylander trying to elude Ponikarovsky. Still with it, and Ponikarovsky is in good shape as it comes in front of the goal. And a big save made there by Raycroft. Spun back behind the net, and Gill plays it to an open wing. Shot is blocked. Ponikarovsky looks to outlet, and he does. Sundin along with Antropov. Antropov is in over the line, dropping for Sundin, going wide. Couldn't get the shot through as Jagr's stick was in the way. Antropov along the near boards. Malik can't play it out past him, and he'll retreat into the Rangers zone. Up on the wing for Straka. Across the line and fed in by Isbister. McCabe ringing the boards, but it'll be trapped there by Shanahan. A drive right on. That was stopped. The rebound back at the point. Scores! Sean Avery coming off the bench ties the game at one.
That's Sean Avery's 17th goal of the season. And with the Rangers, it's his 7th goal and his 17th point. The clear attempt out of the lead zone by Koliakovo goes right to Avery. And he, from 51 feet out, gets the puck by Raycroft.
I don't think Raycroft ever saw it. It's in the net before he even moves a muscle.
I wonder if anybody touched it because it got up in an awful hurry.
Avery discussing maybe that with the linesman now, but it's registered as an unassisted goal. So it is a 1-1 tie here in the first period. Devereaux ahead for Stajan, who gets in over the line. Stajan trying to pull the brakes on. Into the slot. Coverley going to the net. Fires it and went wide of the goal. And Lundqvist was way out of the goal. He scampers practically back in. He was over in no man's land. He had a little of that fresh ice and he went for a slide. Shanahan intercepts. Ahead to Avery. He misses a hit from Coverley. Avery along with Kavina going around back of the net. Avery leaves it there. The puck's still free. And it is Devereaux gathering it up and playing it out at center ice. Steen didn't see it. Rangers shoot it right back in again. Coverley and the Ranger player falling. Change of players here as the crowd was chanting Avery. And now back of the net it goes. The Toronto native has tied the game at one. A pass for Wellwood. He doesn't get it out the first time, but does the second. We're approaching 7 minutes in the first period in a 1-1 tie. Right back into Toronto territory it goes. McCabe around back of the net with Matt Cullen up forechecking a bit. Now the Rangers have peeled right back into the center ice area as McCabe carries the puck out of his own zone. To the red line and off the glass and in it goes. Tucker into the corner, but it's whistled down on an offside at the blue line. You're watching Molson Canadian Leafs Hockey here on TSN. Welcome back to the Big Apple here in New York. Last night, Thomas Coverley was the hero of the game, but the heroine of the night was 28-year-old Julie Beatty of Burlington, a nurse with McMaster University. She jumped into action when a patron went down with an apparent heart attack and provided CPR. Her husband, Paul, informed me today she was sleeping because she has a 12-hour shift tonight. They had not been to a Leaf game in 5 years and won the tickets at a Stag and Dome. And I think I can tell the Beatty family that streak is coming to an end. They will be at a future Leaf game very shortly.
Tuesday or Saturday. It was a great move.
A great bit of work done by a young lady who just did her job. And she did it with a great deal of expertise. And a young gentleman who is in St. Michael's Hospital owes her a great deal for her knowledge and her quick action. As a pass back to the slot and a drive by Koliakova went wide. The rebound is shoveled into the front of the net by Kilgour and a good save made there by Lundqvist. Aired out and down the ice, icing a possibility here in a great foot race that is missed. Koliakova couldn't touch it and he's down back of the goal. Pass in front of the net. Here's a loose puck in front. The backhand shot is turned away and Koliakova is limping to the bench as the Leafs counterattack. In over line Wellwood for Antropov. Doesn't shoot it. Still has it. Antropov back to the point. Gill's drive right on and a good pad save made by Henrik Lundqvist. Koliakova just did get to the bench and is limped over there.
There's another vote for the instant icing.
Rudy Cantu looking at him. Jágr is upended. And the puck goes down into the Toronto zone as the denizens here hollering for a penalty. White up on the right side for Sundin. Sundin with a long shoot-in. And Lundqvist makes sure he has the angle on that.
Well, Koliakovo in a fair amount of discomfort as he slid into the board after he touched the puck in that race here against Kruka. Oh, Jesus. Right leg. Right there.
Wow.
Oh, boy, I don't like the looks of that. He's been playing such good hockey.
He is still in some discomfort over there and bent over at the bench. The shot is kicked away by Lundqvist and the Leafs have carried the play in the shot department 9-4 and tied at one. Kavina run off the puck there adroitly by Avery. Avery sends it back into the corner and now it is set out and down the ice in an attempted pass that went astray. Icing will be charged here on the Kavina effort. Yet another update coming from Holly Horton. Holly?
Bad news for Leaf fans. Carolina, Corey Stillman from the point, tipped along the way by Chad LaRose. They would review this to see if it was a high stick. It was not, and it's 3-3.
Well, right from the start of the hockey game, even before the start, Avery trash-talking Tucker, trash-talking Raycroft even. And then another big hit. That's about his third of the hockey game. And Kabina and Avery exchange pleasantries.
5'10", 185.
They desperately needed grit here
in New
York.
Oh, I know they did.
And they went out and got it in a big way. A lot of people thought, well, why would you touch that guy? He's a bit of a circus act, so to speak, off the ice. But he has really kept himself in line.
Well, if it is, he was here early because the circus was in town, and he's added a goal. Here's Jager, working on the near boards, tried to cycle it in and does get it back of the net. Here's Bister, being hounded there by Devereaux. They exchange the puck, and here's Nylander coming right out in front of the goal! Shoots and scores! Michael Nylander, what a bit of stick handling to gain the area in front, and he makes it 2-1.
That's a six-game point streak, 3 goals, 5 assists for Nylander. He hangs onto the puck, 2 or 3 different twists and turns, and then goes right across in front where Raycroft just wasn't big enough to get there.
The one thing I know about Nylander, he has the ugliest stick in the entire National Hockey League. This guy can't shoot the puck with that stick, so he tends to hold onto it. It's absolutely, utterly ugly, but he gets it done with that stick. And you know, the reason that that faceoff was in the Leaf zone, the play of Avery, the Leafs had to ice the puck, Rangers got the change, they put the big line out, and the Leafs weren't able to make a change. They didn't get their matchup.
25th of the year for Nylander, and it is 2-1 New York. After the first period, about to be played as it's offside at the Toronto blue line.
And number 68. Well, Avery, he stick handles, he yaps, he takes you out. And he gets under your skin, that's for sure. And he's either fearless or crazy. One of the two or both. At 5'10", 185, yapping at Big Gill for Kabina.
So I'm taking a list here. So it is Tucker in warm-up, Raycroft in warm-up. It has been Kabina. That was just John Pohl.
Just keep chalking him up.
Yeah, here we go. We'll get to 20. But, Harry, for 9 minutes of this hockey game, there hasn't been a more dominant player.
No, there hasn't. And he has given them a shot in the arm that they desperately needed in the energy department and in the physical department.
And coming over from L.A., who are not going to make the playoffs, this had to be a bonus to be in a playoff hunt as the pass goes across the goal mouth there from Battaglia. Knocked out at center ice. Great news. Carlo Poliakovo back into the game. Played out into the center ice area. It's flipped into the Toronto bench. And it will be faced off as a result inside the Toronto zone. Well, the circus was in town. And earlier today, here it was with everything set up. And at about 5 minutes to two, holy mackinaw, look at these guys work. And the hurry-up offense was on as far as the cleanup was concerned. And off went the floorboards, and here comes the ice. Heels, you've played here after the circus. What is the ice like?
It's the same as it is always, guys. Terrible. The ice stinks here all the time. Let's face it. You know, I played here when they had a basketball game in the afternoon, circus in the morning, and a hockey game at night.
Perfect.
So, talk about multi-use facilities.
Yep. Lifted in on a delayed offside. Battaglia gets to it. Now the Leafs are changing, and Battaglia is trying to fend it off to get some fresh troops out there. Whoa! And a hit there coming through was Antropov. He has the puck at the blue line and in with a shot. And it's into the chest protector of Lundqvist and Hell. 2-1 Ranger. You're watching Molson Canadian Leafs Hockey here on TSN.
Summary of Shanahan's work, and here's a statistical summary of how he has done for the 5 teams he's played for, and he overcame a terrible collision and a fairly severe concussion that cost him about a month. But he appears to be back in order, getting ready for, he thinks, and hopes the playoffs.
Face off to the right of Lundqvist. The Rangers lead 2-1 on goals by Avery and Nylander after Alexei Ponikarovsky opened the scoring on the power play for Toronto. Antropov wins the draw. Sundin shot went off a leg and fluttered wide of the net. Is Bister along the near boards. Top lines out against each other here as the Rangers regroup in their own zone. Merrick Malik. A lead pass at center, trying to flip it in there for Yager, and it's cut off by Antropov. Kaberle mishandles the puck, but is able to regain it quickly. Now up the middle to Sundin, chipped in over the line. Antropov trying to get back to the blue line as he spun around on a collision with the Ranger player. Now Nylander. Ugly stick and all, according to Glenn Healy. Stick handling and now heading to the bench.
Glenn, how many times have I told you don't make fun of a player's stick, girlfriend, or wife, and not necessarily in that order.
That's right. Now, I played a game in Chicago when he was playing with the Blackhawks, and he made me look absolutely stupid on one particular play. Same thing there. I think he went around Alex Karpatsev about 15 times before he went around me. But it was pretty easy to go around Dean Martin at that time.
You were playing the role of Jerry Lewis.
I really like those guys. Played up on the wing and now on the left side for Shanahan, too far. And it is Koliakovo curling, and we get a stick lost or a penalty coming here to Toronto, I believe. Darcy Tucker took a healthy run at Sean Avery, and here's the call. Our first indication that the he's not, you know, for all that time in Hollywood, he did take some acting lessons, I think.
His best friend was Audie Murphy.
So Tucker gets a penalty. Watch this. Here's the hit. Oh, my.
Oh.
That wasn't bad. It's they got the Oscars are over, but that's worthy of note. But a penalty here to the Leafs, and the Rangers are on the power play. And they've got the sixth best power play in the National Hockey League. 74 goals and 390 opportunities.
Nine in the last 36 power plays.
Here is Yager. He'll organize it as he gets across the line. He drops it back to the blue line. Throws the ball to the far side, gets it returned. Now Yager on the far half boards as Straka works the right point. Yager down low and into the corner. Gets it returned. Yager trying to come to the front of the net as Bister was turned around. Kruka in front of the goal. And the shot by Straka went wide. Knocked high, and it's going into the screening and out of play. And it will be brought back. Well, the game is decided in Carolina. Holly Horton, who won it? 86 points now for the Carolina Hurricanes with three games left. They are in Tampa in two nights' time, then home to Atlanta and Florida to complete their season. Shanahan back to the point. Gets it returned. Shanahan holding, fakes the shot, let it go. It was knocked down in front of the net. A bouncing disc is recovered by Devereaux and pushed the rest of the way down the ice. 44 seconds remaining here in the penalty. Quickly through center is Pope. Played in on the right side for Matt Cullen. It comes around on the near side. Kabina looking for an outlet. Almost scored. A heck of a save made there by Raycroft. Not sure if that went off the Ranger stick or not, but Kabina was trying to get it back of the net. Shanahan around on the boards. Avery gets it to the point. Shot is wide of the Leaf goal. Cullen trying to recover the loose puck. Kabina does. Got it to the line. Sundin couldn't get it out. Shanahan a drive. Oh, what a blocking arm save that was from Raycroft. Down the boards for Pope. Back to Shanahan. Far side, the one-timer. Scared out of the air.
Well, Raycroft, two big-time saves on this power play for the Rangers. And let's have a look at the last one. No rebound when you catch it. Oh, and we got some people talking over here now.
That was the first one on the blocking arm. And then Shanahan in a little bit of a discussion with Pavel Kabina as they head to their respective benches. It's 6:06 remaining in the period. And a face-off coming to the left.
Okay, just so you were clear that he's going to yap at everybody tonight. Now, he's not yapping at a player, so the players are safe. It's Keith Acton. Not even the coaches are safe.
Get a helmet, Keith. Poliakovo lays it around the boards. That's skipped by Roosevelt. Icing waved off, and Roosevelt scampers back. Had some problems there with Bates Battaglia, but is forced out, and he gets it out into the center ice area for Nylander. Now to Jágr. Jágr across the line. Rolled off Roosevelt's stick. He gets it around back of the net, though. Now the wraparound attempt was blocked. The rebound is intercepted by Gill and played off Battaglia to center ice. Roosevelt back in over the Leaf blue line. Is Bister to the right wing boards. Has it go high and into the screen and out of play. The Rangers 2 and the Leafs 1 here in the first.
Guys, from ice level, the ice is borderline pathetic. And you're going to have to play that when you put together your game plan. This puck is bouncing like it's a tennis ball. Power play, it's tough to even make plays. Like, this thing is all over the place. You're going to have to get a lacrosse stick to play the period. So you've got to take that into consideration. You've got to simplify your game. You've got to get pucks deep. You've got to get pucks at the net.
The discussion continues. Darcy Tucker and Sean Avery. Here with the fist. Oh, right on the button. Darcy Tucker hit him with the right hand. Now he's fighting. He's got a little bit of an assist from the glove and the helmet in front. Avery comes back with a right. Down goes Tucker. Will there be an additional penalty here?
Will there be an instigator?
That's the point.
Tucker was the first to declare he wanted the battle. Avery looked like he might turn him down and then decided to take him on.
This has been going on since the warm-up. A pair of 16s discussing the issue. A linesman leaning in to get a recording. And as soon as the puck was dropped, the discussion turned into something a little more. And hello, pardon me, but I'm right here. And off comes the gloves, and the punches were thrown.
No additional
penalties. I would suggest Darcy Tucker may have got a break there. He was obviously the one that wanted to start things first. Here's Shanahan back of the net trying to center. And it comes to John Pohl on the right wing. Rink wide for Wellwood. Back for Pohl. Pohl to the line and in. Kilgore going to the front of the net, but the puck won't reach him. Kilgore gets to it along the near boards. Trying to play it back to the blue line, but it comes out at center. Kabina will send it diagonally into the left wing side, and Lindqvist back of the goal, pumps it back around. Cut off by Pohl. Can't get it in deep, and it is cleared out at center ice by New York. But it goes into the penalty box area and out of play. So there is still a 2-1 New York lead.
Maurice knew this was going to be a tough game. The Rangers are rolling, and so are the Leafs. But this hasn't been a friendly rink. Since the new year, both these teams have identical records, 21-12-5, after both teams having a slow start.
Pass in for Ponikarovsky. He scored the lead goal on a power play to open the scoring. Sundin and Malik overskate the puck. And the Rangers trying to come out. A nice play made by Ponikarovsky to steal, but then Antropov couldn't find Sundin. The tennis ball will work its way back into the Leafs. It's like a ball up in one of those Aussie rule football games, Heels.
It's something you've got to deal with.
Yep. Jágr around back of the net. Gets it back to the point. Roosevelt will send it towards the goal, smothered by Raycroft after making the save.
Great defensive play by Malik. And his plus minus is absolutely incredible. In the past 4 years, this guy, and I'm going to do the math real fast, plus 113. I mean, 03, 04, he was a plus 35. He just gets it. Now, there's the turnover, but it's the team's response. Malik gets in the lane. He understands, hey, chances are the puck's going to go to the big guy, the captain, and he makes sure he gets in the way.
It bounces off Steen as he hustles after it down the board, but couldn't get it. Loose puck in the slot, and the Rangers will carry it out and send it down the ice. Alex Steen, at home, 4 goals, 8 assists, 12 points, minus 17. On the road, 10 goals, 12 assists, 22 points, plus 24. And he's not alone. Matty Stajan is plus 14 on the road, minus 8 at home. It's been the problems the Leafs have had until most recently on home ice, where they've now won 7 in a row after last night's overtime victory. A pass is going to score! By Devereaux from Kamina, I believe. But Kamina's point shot finds the back of the net. It's tied at 2.
Well, I'm not sure that touched anybody on the way in. Boyd Devereaux might have got his stick on it. Kamina, who's got a real good shot from the point. Here comes Devereaux. And from about 15 or 20 feet in front of the net, Devereaux gets his stick on it, I think, and redirects it. Faberle will get an assist. And the Leafs have tied it up. We'll have to wait for the official score, but it looks like Devereaux tipped it.
So Boyd Devereaux, with his 8th goal of the season, has tied the game at 2s. Slipped into the Ranger zone. Lundqvist gave it away to Hole, who tried to center. Now gets it back from Battaglia. Overskated it. Now reverses his field. Battaglia trying to help out. Koliakovo hollering for a pass, but couldn't get it. Against the boards, Daniel Girardi ties up Pohl around on the wall, and Koliakovo won't be able to keep this in as it comes to center ice. Leafs 2, Rangers 2 here in the period. First period with 2:46 to go. Roosevelt brings it across the line into the slot with a shot. The blocking arm save made by Raycroft. There to the line and out.
Great sequence at the bench there, guys, just a moment ago. You know, they announced the goal to Devereaux. Matt Sundin, I know he's only got one goal in 16. He doesn't care. Stood up and gave Devereaux a real big cheer.
11-10, the shots favoring Toronto. Sundin into the corner. Couldn't handle it, but Ponikarowski frees it up for him. Sundin, back to the point it goes. Kept in by Gill, and back of the net, it'll come to the Leaf captain. Into the near corner. Left there for Antropov. Antropov with Sundin going to the net. Back to the point to Gill, and he couldn't knock it down to keep it in. Ian White. A pass ahead. Ponikarowski can't get in. Here is Jágr coming back the other way. Surrounded by Leafs as he drops it back. Backhand shot. Stop. Rebound. It's knocked into the corner.
Penalty to the Leafs.
And Ian White, I think, put the grab on Brad Isbister's stick. So the Rangers will go to their second power play of the period.
Well, Ian White's a small for a defenseman, and the Rangers have got some big forwards. Ponikarowski turns the puck over, and Jágr, at 235 pounds, is a hard guy to handle for anybody, let alone a guy Ian White's size. There was the penalty call right there.
Rangers 0 for 1 on the power play. 2 of their 11 shots came with the first opportunity. The draw won by the Leafs, and Gill will turn to the side of his own goal and send it out at center ice. Pope, a pass for Shanahan. That was at the side, then goaltender Raycroft couldn't handle in the non-trapezoidal area, and it's brought out into the center ice area, and flipped by Stajan deep into the Ranger end.
Get my dictionary for that. Not a trapezoid. Sounds like an animal in the circus. Yeah,
could have been. Back into the corner it goes. Kamina and Faberle assist on the Devereaux goal. Gobbled up by Faberle, but then turned over. Shanahan centers in front of the goal. Down low. A shot off the side of the goal. Fans thought it was in as it's cleared to the line, but not out. Kept alive on the boards by Paul Mara. Round back of the net, it goes for Jágr coming out in front. And that was deflected by Faberle just enough to get it to Kamina, who has an easy time of icing the puck. The Leafs will get a bit of a break in that this penalty will be dissected somewhat by the intermission. 36 seconds to go in the first period. Nylander to the line, and Straka was in early on the left wing, and so it is going to be faced off outside the Toronto blue line.
Tom Rennie's done a nice job with this team. They got off to a slow start. They've got about 8 or 9 free agents. And he's finally got these guys playing together. And it's not been an easy place to keep a job if you're a coach. Tom Rennie, the 7th since 97-98.
Draw won by the Leafs. Gill had some difficulties with the puck. Now runs into traffic in his own zone. Still free as it comes back to the point. Kept in there by Mara. Or Malik, rather, into the corner. Gill now back to the goal. Got it freed up. Sundin scoops it but can't get it out. Back to the near side it comes. Into the slot and a drive is deflected in front of the Leaf goal. Played along the boards with 6 seconds left. Now back of the net, the Rangers try to center, and Sundin intercepts. And that will do it for the period.
Well, a wide-open first period, and probably both teams deserve the spot they're in, tied.
And a big period for Avery. I think he was a star in the first period. Goals, bunch of big hits, and certainly getting some of the Leafs off their game.
12-11, the shots favor the Rangers. Deadlocked at twos at the end of the first period in New York. Welcome back, and you can see the traffic jams in New York City as the Leafs are in a traffic jam trying to get into the postseason, as are the Rangers. And a look at our first period summary. Alexei Ponikarovsky on the power play equals his goal output from a year ago. Then Avery and Nylander scoring for the Rangers. And Boyd Devereaux from Kabina and Coverle is the tying goal for the Leafs. And we have VTech winners who are going to be receiving those lovely VTech phones, the IA-5849, coming up.
Devereaux tipped in a Kabina shot, and Ponikarovsky was all alone in front of the net. But nobody but the goalie to beat, and he beat him.
Devereaux scoring at a 567 clip, getting points in games. That's this season. Over his career, 275. So he has really been a nice addition to the Leafs' offense this season.
That's four goals in the last six games for Boyd Devereaux.
We start with the Leafs still a man short, the second power play of the game for the Rangers. Jágr dropping it off. Brought in over the line now by Nylander. He works his way into the corner. Nylander getting it back to the point, settling it down there as Malik with a shot that is deflected off McCabe wide, and White is back into the fray. Back of the goal for Nylander, chased by Hal Gill. Nylander works back, got away from Gill's check. Sundin closes down and deflects the pass to the side of the goal. Raycroft finds it, and he will hold on. Jágr and McCabe exchanging shoves in front of the goal.
Rangers outchanced the Leafs 6-5 in the first period, now shot them 12-11.
Well, there is tension at this time of year, not only for broadcasters and players. How about the general managers? Ferguson's done a pretty good job of putting this team together. A lot of pieces of the puzzle. And do these guys look relaxed to you? Now, you wonder why they're going to have a little bit of gray hair, but it's situations like this that make the night so rewarding.
That was last night's game, and the reaction from Thomas Coverley is Jeff Jackson and John Ferguson watching the game together. A hit there spins the Ranger to the ice as Kabina got a piece of him, and it is Coverley now on the far side. Kabina returns the favor, as does Coverley. And Kabina gets it ahead to Chad Kilger. Drop pass, Wellwood now looking for Tucker, who is out onto the ice after serving his major penalty. Wellwood against the board, centered, and Tucker wasn't ready for it. Straka banks it ahead at center. Long shoot in on Raycroft. He has to get out to recover the rebound, and Kilger finds Coverle, who finds Wellwood, who finds Boyd Devereaux. Devereaux in with a shot, and Lundqvist had that go right over his shoulder and over the net. Now the Rangers back in on the right side. Callahan driving the net, a shot to Novello, and they score!
Raycroft made the initial stop, and the puck went up over his head. And rolls into the net. And Ryan Callahan's going to get his fourth of the season, and this is 11th game. And you can see Raycroft had no idea where it was, and when he found it, it was in the wrong spot. There's the shot. It looked like a harmless shot. And the Rangers go ahead with kind of a funny one.
The only puck might have been, did Callahan touch it with a high stick, but it was over the stick of Poliakovo, and then Raycroft made the save, and up into the air it went and over the shoulder, and it is 3-2 New York. Raycroft around for Koliakovo. Losing his stick there was the Ranger forward in the forecheck. Now McCabe knocks his man down and comes away with a loose puck. McCabe, a rink-wide pass, and Devereaux will launch from Steen, and Steen are across the line, into the slot, and Steen couldn't redirect. Steen sends it to the net that's high and wide. Ian White with a bouncing puck to contend with just kept it in. Round back to the net for Steen. Steen curling out with it. Plays it back in for Steen. Steen to Steen, and a bouncing puck there went right over his stick. Cleared out and down the ice by Matt Cullen into the center ice area. Jeb Ortmeier gets the lone assist on the goal as a hit there sent Ryan Callahan into the sideboard. Back down into the Ranger zone it goes, and Paul Mara will touch up an icing.
Well, let's have a look at Callahan. Ryan Callahan had 55 points in 60 games with Hartford, their American League affiliate, and it was just a routine shot. And I don't know what happened to Raycroft on it, but he lost it after it hit him in the lop blocker.
That's a puck that should be stopped, guys. I mean, he shoots that puck from where the goal judge sits in Toronto at the games. And we have seen some goals down that wing for Raycroft on a number of occasions. It is a troublesome spot for him when shooters come down the right wing. Whether he's addressing the puck, he's covering his angles, or staying square, there's certainly this is more than a one of. It's a trend down that side of the ice.
Callahan looked like he almost got his stick on the puck to knock it down right at the goal line. Knocked out into the center ice area, and Battaglia sends it back. The goal was not reviewed by any stretch of the imagination, so obviously the official there felt that he did not touch the puck. As Paverley takes it around back of the net. Long, I guess that was a pass intended there for Battaglia, but it's going to turn into an icing charge.
Chiefs have won six in a row at home, and they really had a good road record going, but in the last five, it has not been impressive, only 2 points.
In the previous nine road games, Harry, they were 7-1-1. So while they got things fixed at home, the wheels have come off a bit on the road.
A part of the problem, too, for the Leafs at home, I think, early on, is that they never have a stretch where they have five, six, seven games at home. They have three, and then they go back on the road. One, and then they're back on the road. So they don't get that long, extended stretch because of the multi-use facility that the Air Canada Centre is.
Raycroft getting some equipment adjusted. And this hockey broadcast is available on TSN HD, Canada's sports leader in high definition. A draw to the right of Raycroft. Perreault got the puck to the boards, and Coverley has it around back of the net. Off the wall, it goes to Battaglia, who tips for Hole, who gets it in deep. Roosevelt playing it around to the far corner for Merrick Malik. And the defenseman runs into some problems there. Here's Sundin off the board, working into the corner. Centers in front, Ponikarovsky to Coverley. It comes back to the point and kept in there by Antropov, who was filling in for the Leaf defenseman. Ponikarovsky to Coverley. Over to Kabina. Kabina sends the shot to the net. It's deflected and knocked down. And Malik will get it to the line and sent to center ice. Kabina for Ponikarovsky. Ponikarovsky taking the puck wide. Pinned to the boards there by Roosevelt and knocked down on the play. The puck goes free to Antropov, however. Antropov looking for an outlet and against the wall loses it, and Isbister will carry it out with Jágr. Jágr in across the line, puts the brakes on, works it back to the point coming off the bench, and a pass in front, and Nylander didn't get his stick on it. McCabe counters now for the Leafs. To center with Ponikarovsky, dropping for Antropov. Pass in front for Sundin went astray. And the three forwards who've been on for a long shift are heading back. Here's Shanahan dropping it back and Spalding to block. That a couple, but they score! Straka!
Well, the big line for the Leafs. And they're going to make a goaltending change now as Aubin is going to go in and relieve Raycroft. But the Sundin line got caught. It's a 4-on-2 rush. And the Rangers, with some good pass and a little luck on that bounce that came off the Leaf defenseman's skate, right to Straka.
29th of the year for Marty Straka. What a great pass. It goes off McCabe's foot right to Marty Straka for his 29th. And Jean-Sebastien Aubin has come into goal to replace Andrew Raycroft.
And Raycroft had started and finished 16 straight coming into this one. And the Rangers get ahead 4-2 here early in the second period.
White turns back in his own zone, and here is Gill playing it in off the stick of Wellwood. Along the boards, it's going to turn into an icing charge and come back into the Toronto zone.
How much more of a factor can Avery be in this hockey game? I mean, this guy, if he fell in a pile of elephant, you know what I mean, the puck could end up in the net. Watch this play here. Toe pick. Oops. He throws it at the net. It goes off a skate. He's not even watching it. It's in. So he's got a goal in the first period. He drew a penalty for the second goal. He creates the fourth goal. And he's got everybody in the ring mad at him but his own team.
A lead pass for Kilger. And down the ice. And an icing charge here against Toronto will bring it back into the Leafs on to the right. While he has been that kind of a player throughout his career, there have been more problems possibly off ice with some of his comments. But you're right. He's got it underneath everybody's skin, and they are all thinking about him. He'll take the face off here.
I wonder if he knows Kenny Lynn.
I think he went to his hockey camp, to be honest with you. Avery waved out. Shanahan draws the additional assist on the goal. And it's 4-2. Centering pass, and off the glove of Aubin. A good save there. The 16s run into one another again. Here are the Rangers trying to center, and sprawling to block that was Hal Gill. Played ahead now, and here is White carrying to center. Off the boards and chipped in by Chad Kilger. Wellwood being hunted down there by Shanahan. Now Tucker gets the puck to him. Back it comes from Wellwood. And it is Shanahan out fighting him for the disc and bouncing it out and down the ice. Brendan Shanahan, since coming back from the concussion, 6 games played. He has 6 assists.
Well, Shanahan's going to feel pretty good by the time the playoffs come around. And when you get the injury he had, it takes a little while for you to get everything together again.
Well, how about the play he makes here, Harry? He's the third guy back, makes a good defensive play, and then battles down low. Doesn't make a fancy play, just gets rid of it. He knows they've got a 2-goal lead. Now they're playing the score in the clock.
A glove pass from Coberlé to Stajan is whistled down, and it will be faced off outside the blue line.
I meant to tell you, Glenn, that I went to that restaurant for lunch that you recommended.
Okay.
I said to the waiter, what do you recommend? And he says, get out of here while you still can. So I'm not taking any more hints from you.
Another lovely day in Manhattan.
Boy, it was crowded on the streets today.
Yes, it was. Our area where we stay is right in the theater district, and lots of people were down. Coberlé ahead for Steen. To the red line and in, clipping it into the corner. Lundqvist out of the goal to pump it back. Devereaux shovels it along. Now it is Steen, bumped there, but coming out with the disc. Tried to send the shot to the net. He fanned on it. Now it is Stajan to Steen again. Around to the near corner it comes, and Devereaux and Stajan are in pursuit. The Leafs double team it along the boards. Devereaux gets it in a little deeper, and it is caromed around, and now is set out and down the ice by New York. That will result in an icing charge. So the Rangers have scored 2 second period goals and lead 4-2. Earlier tonight we talked about heroes. Well, at 5:30 a.m. on April 9th, 1917, 30,000 Canadians under the command of Lieutenant General Sir Julian Byng went over the top at Vimy Ridge. Nearly 3,600 were killed, 7,000 wounded. The monument has been restored at Vimy Ridge, and a new dedication ceremony will be held Easter Monday, April 9th, exactly 90 years from the beginning of the battle. And God bless you, Heels. You will be there with your comrades, and we want to thank you.
Yes, we're going to do a little bagpiping, and there's going to be 3,600 students from across Canada, and one for each of the soldiers that died at Vimy Ridge, and they're going to wear the uniforms, the dog tags. It's the birthplace really of Canada. That's where we became a nation.
You're right about that. Shot out into the center ice area and down. It's going to be an icing charge if Tarpley gets to it, and he will, and bring it back into the New York zone.
Well, Ray Kropke can't be held responsible for the fact that the Leafs are down by two. 51 shots, 8 goals. And here are the two in the second period. This one by Callahan. I don't know what happened to him on that one. And then on the next one, it hit the skate of Koliakovo, I think it was, or McCabe,
I think,
went right onto the stick of Straka. So that was a little bit of bad luck.
He's done yeoman work, though, guys. From December 30th to March 2nd, he started 26 straight. And really, the only reason that the Leafs are right in the hunt has been exceptional goaltending.
Well, that's been the least of their problems almost every night. And as I mentioned earlier, Toronto in the new year have won 21, 12, and 5, went into extra time.
And he's just one victory away from equaling Ed Belfour's record for season victories.
It's unfortunate. You're certain teams you play really well against, and the Rangers are one team he has played historically great against. He only lost one time in his whole career against the New York Rangers.
Up on the right side is Ortmeier, as he lifts it in over the head of McCabe. And they're going to call this icing as well, I believe. Yep, it's coming all the way back into the New York zone, despite the protestations of the New York bench.
That's 4 straight icings by the Rangers in about the last 6 minutes. And the Rangers are complaining a little bit. There it is right there.
And it's not a pass. That is icing.
The pass if it's the New York Giants playing the New York Jets.
I think the Knicks. Draw to the right, and it is Perreault taking the draw for the Leafs. Wins it cleanly. McKay back at the point. A one-timer flutters to the net, and that almost handcuffed Lindqvist. He had to wait patiently for it to get there. Oh, it is shot down the ice, and the fans applauding the Ranger change.
It wasn't icing. We're going to start that chant, icing sucks, if we're not careful.
No, we can't. Colton Orr sending it down into the Leafs zone. Round back of the net, flipped into the corner. Orr able to knock it down, looking in front of the net there for Blair Betts. And unable to retrieve it. And it is cleared out into the center ice area. And here is Battaglia weaving in on the right side. Puts the brakes on. A cross ice feed for Pohl in front of the goal. And Perreault couldn't redirect. Penalty coming to the New York Rangers. Shot in front. Pohl took a swipe at it and missed. And for some reason, the whistle went.
Rangers certainly did not have control of the puck to take the delayed penalty off. Colton Orr is going to get the penalty. He doesn't agree with it.
A tripping penalty to Orr will send the Leafs to the power play. Is it a bit of a dive?
I would say Greg Louganis was in on that one.
I just want to know, guys, do we have 1,000 cameras covering this game?
Yes, we do.
Who ISO'd Colton Orr on a shift where we could get that penalty up close and personal?
It was an honest mistake. They thought his name was Bob.
68. No, 28.
Ah,
oops.
All right. Back to the point it comes. Coverlé for McCabe. Back to Thomas Coverlé. Coverlé returns to McCabe. Back to Coverlé. Across ice feed and Tucker. One-timer. But it was from a long way away and a long pass. And it gave Lundqvist plenty of time to get across.
And a bad angle. So it was a hard shot, but not much chance of going in.
Other than that, it was fine. Up at center, Sundin. Little move there to drop it back. Gets it returned. Tucker's in front. A pass to Coverlé. A drive right on. The rebound in front of the goal. Sundin doesn't shoot it. And it's going to trickle off his stick to center ice. Coverlé off a Ranger stick. Off to center. Now trying to bring it in is McCabe. And it is shot down the ice by New York. Minute 13 to go in the power play. After tonight, the Leafs and the Canadians have 3 games left each. They will play those games on the same evening, April the 3rd, 5th, and of course, meeting each other in Toronto next Saturday on the 7th. The Leafs are 1 point back of Montreal, but are certainly behind the Canadians in wins, which is the tiebreaker. And it's not without the possibility of the two teams meeting next Saturday, and the Leafs, despite the fact the game is tied in the third period, having to pull their goaltender to win in regulation time in order to secure a playoff berth. It's that close. Here's Kabina, just keeping it in. White, Antropov, looking for Ponikarovsky in front. Back to Ian White, return to Nick Antropov. Antropov down low, pass in front, Kabina's there! Shot, rebound, shoveled in front of the goal, but not out. White lets it go, great save made by Lundqvist, and it's shot out and down the ice by New York. Out of the penalty box is Orr. White and Orr rampaging around into the near corner. He heads to the bench now, and the crowd is chanting Lundqvist's name. Round into the corner for Kabina. Rangers cycling the puck. It's back of the net, and a penalty for holding here to Jagr. The Leafs go back to power play hockey when we return.
Daniel Girardi, who's another one of the recalls from Hartford. Kabina makes the first, and then Girardi makes the second save. And then Lundqvist makes a great stop off White as the puck's going through all kinds of legs. And Jagr gets a holding penalty right there. He grabbed Kabina and gave him a yank.
Olympic teammates and Jagr to the box. Third power play for the Leafs. They had two of the four power play shots that they have mustered in their total of 18 on the last advantage.
I can tell you guys that the Rangers bench, you think they'd be poised and calm and cool with a two-goal lead. They're not. Coaching staff is hot. Field players are letting the game slip a little bit. And the next goal puts the Leafs back in the hockey game.
Here is Sundin curling out of his own zone. Their first period goal came with a man advantage as McCabe shovels it in. Lundqvist out of the goal to play it back. Avery looking for an opportunity to clear. And a bouncing puck comes to the point, kept in by McCabe. Spinning pass to Sundin. Sundin into the slot for McCabe. Doesn't shoot it. Kaberle holds. Kaberle looking back to the point. Gives it off on the wing. Gets it back from Wellwood. Back for Kyle Wellwood. He moves to the middle of the ice to McCabe in the drive. Blocking on save. Rebound in front. And it's dug into the corner by Avery. And will be set out and down the ice. Kaberle and Wellwood back in the Toronto zone, reorganizing the attack. Kyle Wellwood, the Windsor, Ontario native, up on the wing. It goes to Tucker, dropping it back. Sundin finds Kaberle. A pass is blocked, and trying to turn it back up ice is Shanahan. Shanahan closes in, and he hit the side of the goal. Batted ahead, and out comes the Leafs. Sundin for Wellwood. Wellwood in over the line. Spins away from a check. Centers in front of the net. A shot. Oh, Tucker had it blocked by Shanahan, who slid across. Great play by the veteran. Wellwood leaves for Sundin. Sundin down low looking at Wellwood and finding him. Wellwood trying to get the cross crease pass goes back to the net. Tucker pokes it back to McCabe. McCabe saucers it to Kabina. Kabina winds and shoots. Oh, that was blocked by Girardi, and that's going to leave a mark. Down the ice it goes for New York. 10 seconds left in the power play. 7:38 to go, second period. Rangers by a pair as it's shot in by Pavel Kabina with the Leafs changing in the go. And the penalty is over to Jagr, who's back onto the ice. Matt Cullen banks it ahead to the former scoring champion, and into the corner he goes. Centered in front of the net, cut off there by Antropov. Off a skate to Ponikarovsky as Perro joins the rush. Ponikarovsky for Antropov. Tried to reach back to gain possession. Played it into the corner, but not far enough for Perro. And slammed into his van as Gill keeps it in. And Perro's weak shot is directed wide by Lundqvist. Antropov knocked down from behind and engaged by Michael Roosevelt. Puck still free. Ponikarovsky managed to get it in front as Antropov had lost his stick. 3-on-2 rush, but out of the reach of Jagr. Gill, who had an excellent game against Jagr here the last time the Leafs were in town, played around back of the net. 4-2 New York. Nylander, one of the goal scorers, slips it in, and White has to battle his man Isbister. Is Bester trying to cycle it back? Cut off by Podkarowski. Is Bester loses it, and Devereaux breaks with Perreault. Perreault to center will diagonally shoot it in and peel to the bench as Devereaux provides the forecheck, but a quick pass goes back of the net. Having some difficulty with Pope. Down goes Steen, but he's back in his skates, trying to find an outlet for that pass as Stajan goes after a loose puck. Stajan sends it to the point. Koliakovo sends it in along the boards. Against the wall, Steen and Stajan trying to dig it out. Good work done here by Thomas Pope to force it to the line, but kept in by Koliakovo. Goaltender Lundqvist to the far side. Devereaux trying to find some room. Does. Devereaux played it back behind for Stajan and Steen. Now Stajan back of the net. Centers in front. Oh, and Devereaux with his quick shot set it just wide. Good work by the Leafs here, and a shot is blocked and smothered by Lundqvist. The Leafs trail by a pair. You're watching Molson Canadian Leafs Hockey on TSN.
Lundqvist having another strong night. And I saw something in warm-up I've never seen from any goaltender. This is warm-up. This is starting goaltender. Practicing breakaways? I mean, Berdur doesn't do it in practice. This guy does it in the pregame skate. Absolutely incredible.
I'll tell you what. In 47 shootout shots, he's allowed just 8 goals. Not a bad idea for a goaltender, maybe, to get a little work in prior to the game.
Maybe I should have done that.
Well, there you are.
I'd be wearing number 30 like he's...
Well, he's got an
eight, my number.
An 8-3 record in shootouts, Hill. So I think that might be one of the reasons, and maybe something for the other goaltenders to think about, too.
Now, when Billy Smith played with the Islanders, he warmed up for about 4 minutes at the end of warm-up, and you couldn't shoot the puck over his knees, or he broke his stick on your back. This guy, you think there's a change in the position?
Yeah.
Yeah. He's practicing breakaways in the pregame skate.
I remember John Anderson telling me that he spent the whole warm-up trying to hit Mike Palmatier and couldn't. Now here are the Rangers in the corner trying to come out in front. They do. They score!
That's Avery's 18th goal, and he has really grabbed this New York team and the New York fans by the throat, and they really get a kick out of this guy. Looked like a harmless play with not much going. And Avery was allowed to walk out from behind the icing line. Here's another look at it. Puck harmlessly thrown into the corner, and then Aubin fires it around, and Avery will grab it.
That's made a nice play to take the man off, and Avery comes right out of the corner and scores. So he is having a career night. And a 2-goal, 1-assist performance from Sean Avery has the Rangers very much in command. Chance in front of the net, and Aubin stopped that as a lead pass is too far for Podkarowski to reach. An unassisted goal for Avery, his 18th of the year, and a long shot is stopped by Lundqvist, and he's going to hold on.
Well, Sean Avery has been the most popular player on the Rangers, and Avery may have seen this guy play, Esa Tiikkanen, who's got a little Avery in him, or Avery's got a little Tiikkanen in him. Yeah.
He may have gone to the Tiikkanen hockey school as opposed to the Ken Linsman one.
And then they introduced him, and he got a big hand. He was a member, of course, of the 94 Stanley Cup New York Rangers.
Look, I'll tell you one quick little story about that 94 run. We played the Washington Capitals, and during one of the scrums, he kissed Keith Jones on the lips. The Washington Capitals spent 3 games trying to kill him. And they, before they knew it, they woke up and the series was over. Super pest, you're right. The one difference between him and Avery, Tiikkanen can speak 8 languages, none of which anyone understands from any country.
Well, Avery has reached the 50-goal plateau for his career here tonight. Got back into the New York zone. 4 minutes to play in the second period. After tonight, the Leafs have 2 of the 3 games remaining on home ice. Tuesday night hosting the Flyers, and then into New York to play the Islanders on Thursday, and finishing off with Les Canadiens at the Air Canada Centre on Saturday. Gill off the boards for Kilgren to the line and poked out. Now it's whistled down on the offside by the linesman, and it'll be brought back. Career games against the Leafs. Sean Avery had just one goal. Well, he's got two goals and one assist here tonight. Came over from LA along with John Seymour in exchange for Jason Ward and unsigned forward Marc-Andre Cliche and Jan Marek. So the Rangers got exactly what they wanted in a pest and some toughness and sandpaper, and they're finding he's got a goal scorer's touch. Here's Devereaux. Back to the point to Kabina, and over it comes to Kaberle. Return to Kabina. Back to Kaberle. Return to Kabina. Far side and a shot coming. Kaberle with a one-timer redirected at wide. Kaberle plays it back past Kabina. It's going to go down into the Toronto zone, and Steen will have to chase it down and look up ice. Pavel Kabina on the near wing. Pass deflected by Kaberle into the Rangers zone. Lundqvist reverses it around, and with the Leafs changing, there's an avenue to break it out. Colton Orr slid it in over the line as Battaglia bumped into him. A hit there, and Koliakovo pays the price on a hit from Peter Prucha. This is the Rangers' fourth unit as Koliakovo takes another hit. The puck comes around on the wing. Carroll lays it into the right wing corner. John Pohl in against the boards. Carroll trying to come away with a loose puck as Koliakovo heads to the bench, and White cannot keep it in. Aubin getting it ahead to McCabe. A pass deflected in over the line by Bates Battaglia. Merrick Malik circles the net, and it is cleared to center ice. Al Gill launching it right back into Ranger territory with under 2 minutes to play in the period. Jágr against the boards. Read it up for Nylander. Down on the far side for Malik, and a penalty coming to the Leafs as Lundqvist heads for the bench. Gill will put a stop to the play, and the Rangers will go to their third power play.
Bonikarovsky's going to get it for hooking. And there it is right there. Can't put your stick on the guy and try and hold him up.
18:22, the time of the penalty.
Koliakovo, who got nailed for the second time, goes to the Leaf bench and is really upset at the fact that he's got a problem.
And, you know, I don't even think the problem's from tonight. I think it's just every second night, the war and the tear and the wear and tear of just playing. It's been pressure-filled since the All-Star break for these guys, and they paid the price.
Yes, they have. Brown on the boards. This is the third power play for New York as it comes to the side of the goal. Knocked wide of the net. Rangers 5 and the Leafs 2. And it's played out of play, and there'll be a face-off coming. And up to date, let's take a look at the standings.
The frustrating thing here for Toronto with Carolina winning tonight is the fact that now Toronto's not, that their destiny isn't in their own hands. If they play that last game against Montreal, and Montreal wins, let's say, for instance, in the shootout or in overtime, then Montreal has more wins. So by losing tonight, the Leafs have lost control of their own destiny.
Played out at center. Canadians currently with 88 points, the Leafs with 87. And that's my point, Fields. If everything stayed the same to that last game, the Leafs would have to win in regulation time in order to vault themselves over the Canadians. If they got a single point in the game, it's over.
And if the Leafs had won this evening, that's a different story. Then they run the table, they're in.
On back of the net. Laid up on the left wing side. Jágr trying to play it back. Back down into the Leafs zone it goes. Kabina chases Nylander around back of the net. 22 seconds to go in the period as Nylander gets pulled over in the corner. And it is sent to center ice, and here's a three on. Oh, it's going to be broken up because of the pass And that could not be held on the far side by Boyd Devereaux.
Nylander going into the New York bench under a little duress. He was knocked down in the corner.
.8 seconds to go, and look at the front roll on the reverse roll by Nylander into the corner. Russian judge gave him a 2.
French judge gave him a 9.
Shot down into the Leaf zone, and a big period saluted by the Ranger faithful here as the Rangers have scored 3 unanswered second period goals and lead the Maple Leafs 5-2.
The Leafs got to look at this third period from two angles. One, they'd like to see if they could get the first goal and make the run. But two, they got to get their game back in order to get ready for Tuesday night.
And Lundqvist has been a factor when he's been tested. And Avery continues to be the most valuable player of the hockey game.
Callahan, Straka, and Avery, the goal scorers in the second. It's 5-2 New York. Welcome back to the city that never sleeps. And the Leafs are in a lot of trouble here after two periods of play. A threesome put up on the board by the New York Rangers, Callahan, Straka, and Avery. And our second period summary is brought to you by Capital One. What's in your wallet?
Well, Lundqvist has had to handle 22 Toronto shots and 12 scoring chances. And he's been really sharp as the Leafs have been unable to score on some pretty good opportunities. They've outshot the Rangers. They've outchanced them. They haven't outscored them. And one of the reasons is you're looking at them.
Maybe the biggest save right there made by the Ranger defenseman, because it was a 3-2 hockey game at that point. And a lot more after that. And Lundqvist has been excellent. Power play for New York still in effect with Ponikarovsky in the box, and an icing charge here against New York. It'll come back into the circle to the left of Henrik Lundqvist.
Well, with Lundqvist in the net, you don't get a do-over like I'm sure Graycroft would love to have on the third goal. There's no do-overs, there's no mulligan. The guy simply makes all the saves he's supposed to, and on top of that, the ones he's not supposed to.
Well, they allowed 10 goals in their last two games, and they've obviously tightened things down here in this game with the Leafs.
The game against Montreal where Lundqvist got pulled, I guess the first period that the Rangers played against Montreal was one of their best of the year. And then the second period, the wheels fell right off the cart. 5 goals.
Rolls in wide of the goal. Obam poking it into the corner. Laid up on the wing. Antropov looking to move it ahead, and Sundin throws it high, and it's going to clear the boards and go into the Ranger bench and out of play.
Well, Matt Sundin, that elusive goal that will tie him with Daryl Sittler, has been on the shelf for quite a little while. Sundin is scoring some points, but he can't get that big goal.
No goals in 8 games, and this hockey broadcast is available on TSN HD, Canada's sports leader in high definition. 1 goal in his last 16 games, although he has had 14 points, and he's gained 1 here tonight as well. Now Sundin working it off the wing with a shot, and it went high and wide on the short side. White tried to send it in, but it's bounced out at center ice, and now Gill backhands it back into New York territory. The Rangers, I'm sure, discussed the fact about not sitting on the lead. If the Leafs are able to get one, they might be able to get a little momentum going in the right direction for them. New York, though, Straka counterattacking here.
Avery's
on the right
hurt.
Side.
He's going to the bench. He got hit with that shoot-in in the foot.
And he is limp to the bench. 2 goals on the night. Goes along the boards, Girardi shovels it in, and Obank kicks it over on the far side where it is played around for White. A pass that misfires on an attempt to Wellwood is ruled a pass, however, and the Rangers are not given an icing.
Frederick made no attempt to stop it.
Cullen brings it through center. Trying to straddle the line on the far side over there and spinning down to the ice was Callahan.
Best player for both teams, Sean Avery. He has done it in many different ways. He's intimidated Leafs on the scoreboard. like there, getting the first goal of the hockey game. Physically, he's intimidated a number of Maple Leafs. Gets a big assist from his stomach. And ultimately, the last goal that really puts the nail in the coffin for the Maple Leafs as he drives for the net. He has been a huge factor this evening. He's been a big factor since he's come over at the trade.
Gordie Howe hat trick, isn't it? Goal, assist, and a fight. He's had it all.
And that's, you know, when you look at his job description, he has done it to perfection. And it didn't start when the puck was dropped at the start of the game. It started in warm-up, and he has carried it right through from whistle to whistle. He's been great.
Stajan, Devereaux, and Steen out there for Toronto. Steen wraps it back. Stajan and Devereaux got it ahead, but it's picked off here by Cullen. Cullen across the line, driving the net. He's in a goal! Up ahead for Steen on the left wing with Devereaux going to the net. Big shot and then the drive. Rebound is knocked wide of the goal as Lundqvist made the initial save. Stajan back in the net trying to center. No one there as the Leafs were changing their defense. And it comes to center ice. White and Kavina. Playing it along the boards. Send it down into the corner and flip down into the Toronto zone. Slip back of the net. Here is Harrell rolling it off a skate that went in towards the net. It was covered up there and set aside by Lindqvist. Back of the goal for Thomas Pope. Kabina pinches. Hole tries to keep it in. Harrell can't get a shot as he was spun to the ice. And the Rangers will get clear of it to center ice. In on the left wing now trying to drive the net is Peter Krukin. He loses it. Cole turns it back with a pass at center. That bounced and almost hit Battaglia right in the schnoz.
Fans in the eighth row were ducking.
Roosevelt. Near side for Isbister. The big line for the Rangers is out there again as Gill gets it out in center ice areas. Sundin couldn't handle it. And Gill will corral it back in the Toronto zone. McKay. Puts the brakes on. Gives it back to Hal Gill. Gill up on the wing for Antropov. Antropov and Ponikarovsky. The shot doesn't get through. It bounds to the far boards. It is shoveled out and down the ice by the Maple Leafs. Or by the Rangers. And an icing charge here against them. And the Maple Leafs touching it up.
Well, Yakovo is not on the Leaf bench. He took two thundering hits in the first period on a race for the icing. And he came back in the very next shift. And then Krukin hit him, and I don't think Koliakopo will return tonight. And the Leafs will go with five defensemen for the rest of the game. And he's played some good hockey lately. This hasn't been one of his better nights.
Shot off the goalpost as Kabina is unable to keep it in. Tucker with the drive, and now he sends it back, and Coverle will go back to retrieve it. Or Wellwood, who drops it back. Coverle up on the left side. Kilgers across the line. Sends a rolling shot in wide of the net off the stick of Lundqvist. Wellwood back of the goal for Tucker. He couldn't get it out in front. Snapped along the wall. Kabina pinches to keep it in. Wellwood trying to help him out. The fight is on against the wall as Tucker got it free. Then Kabina's stick was being tied up by Jagr. He complained about that as it shot into the Leaf zone. Straka. Lays it along there for Avery. And out at center ice it comes. Here is Tucker in on the right side. Can't get around the New York player. And it is sent around on the boards to the far side. As Strudwick got it there. And Straka has it out at center. Gill intercepts. Bounce down into the New York zone. Another icing coming here as it's touched by Strudwick. And it'll be brought back.
Well, the Leafs ask themselves, why did we not beat this New York Ranger team? They've let this defense off the hook. Here's an example. Play goes to the corner. Matt Stajan gets the puck. Now, hold on to that puck and cycle like you've done so well. Then he throws it in front to two blue sweaters. Another example. They've let the defense off the hook. This is not the defense from the 76 Canada Cup team. If you cycle a puck and work this group, the back end, they are not going to the Hall of Fame. Instead, by not making them play in areas where they don't want to play, you're losing the game 5-2.
Gill up on the left wing, carried in by Stajan. Cut off there nicely by Girardi, but Stajan gets it back, and a penalty is coming here. A holding call. And Stajan is coming to the penalty box.
Well, this line that's been so good for the Leafs has had a tough night. They were minus six after the second period. Minus two each, and then Stajan picks up a penalty right there. The short little grab on Girardi.
5:20, the time of the penalty to Matt Stajan, and this will be the fourth power play opportunity of the game for the New York Rangers. Paul Maurice, frustrated over the score, obviously, and the tension of this battle down the final week of this season. It is fired deep into the Toronto zone. Tipped by Shanahan back to the point, peppered around into the near corner. Avery back into the game after being injured. Plays it in for Shanahan, back for Avery, back to the point. Left for Shanahan. The drive is deflected by Cullen, just wide of the goal. Back to the point. Another shot goes wide, and it is corralled by McKay, but his backhand doesn't get it out. The Leafs do, and just missing the pass is Chad Kilger. Leafs have just three shorthanded goals this year. Jagr in on the left wing. Nylander is turned away by Kabina as it's sent back down the ice. Minute left to go in the penalty. Roosevelt on to Nylander. Left for Jagr. Jagr into the half-boards area. Centering pass goes to Nylander. Back to the point to Roosevelt. Shot deflects wide of the goal. Jagr on the near boards. Lays it back into the corner. Power play with a 40 seconds left in it. Kruka in front of the net. Here's Jagr with it. Down low. Track to center. They score! Roosevelt coming in off the point. It's 6-2.
Well, that was a real good move by Roosevelt to get himself in position to make that play. The penalty-killing Leafs, left defenseman and left forward, had no idea Roosevelt came off the blue line and from just at the bottom of the circle snaps it in. And Roosevelt gets his 10th goal of the year and his 7th power play goal. Nylander finds him coming off the point. You know the result.
Nylander's 2nd point of the game, Roosevelt's 10th. And the New York Rangers are taking a giant step closer to the postseason. The win here tonight will not guarantee them of a spot. However, they would need another victory. And it may in fact be at the expense of their arch rivals, the New York Islanders, on Tuesday night when they play out on Long Island. Here's Kilger trying to center, and falling on the play was Wellwood. Out at center ice, White for Kilger, and he is going to shoot it in and go to the bench. The Rangers 6 and the Leafs 2. Nylander and Jagr will draw the assists on the Roosevelt goal. Far side now for Kruka. He fans on the shot completely. The Leafs will get it out. John Pohl down the right wing. Lines and shoots. That was blocked and his stick shattered as he got it away. Cut off back of the net by Paul Mara. Now Perro centers. It bounces off the stick of Faberle and is cleared to center ice. And a foot race ensues here with Kruka trying to get around Kabina. He gets it back into the corner and around back of the net. Kruka sending it back. Perro is there. He misses a hit from Colton Orr. As the Leafs try to play it up on the boards, Kabina can't get to it. And it is Pohl rolling it, but not out. Backhanded in deep, and Orr heads to the bench. The Rangers have been full marks here tonight after their win in Philadelphia last night. Both of these teams played last evening. The Leafs, of course, going to overtime before winning in their game against Pittsburgh. But the Rangers in their last two games have scored 12 goals. So their offense is getting well. They came into the game 18th in the NHL with 220 goals scored. The Leafs were 8th with 241. And the Leafs now get it up on the right side for Antropov. Antropov in over the line, dropping for Sundin. The shot is smothered by countryman Henrik Lundqvist.
After that shoulder problem, has 92 points. And here's a summary of some of the trophies that he's won and his career statistics. And there's Boomer Esiason,
former quarterback and now NFL analyst. And the draw coming to the right of a Lundqvist with 10:59 to play in the third period. A shot by White doesn't make it through. That rattled off a shin pad and goes down into the Toronto zone. Aubin will leave it there.
Brad Isbister's going to the benches. He's the guy that blocked that shot.
Aubin has surrendered a couple of goals since replacing Andrew Raycroft. Now here is Jágr in with a shot, and Aubin went low to get the blocking glove in front of that and send it up into the crowd and out of play.
But the 6-2 score for the New York Rangers, this guy's had nothing to do with it. What would it be if he came as a motivated athlete tonight and was a big factor, as big a factor as Avery? He could be in double digits here in New York.
Here's McCabe. A pass for Devereaux doesn't work. Cullen got it in over the line, works to the right wing side. Gill had to go through his legs. Cullen denied access to the front of the net, but it goes back to the blue line. Pope sends it right back in. Gill's long stick was able to intercept that. It's cleared out into the center ice area and quickly snapped right back into the leaf end. Here is Gill getting it ahead. Devereaux will play it in deep. And it is called on the offside at the Ranger blue line. Here is what is on tap. The Leafs have control of their own destiny. If they win three straight and make sure that the third is in regulation time over Montreal, they would finish with 93 points. The Canadiens would finish out of the playoffs unless they were able to tie the game and send it to overtime and would win because of more victories. So this is the extra game the Leafs have to make up. The Carolina Hurricanes, if they run the table, would finish with 92 points. The Leafs, if they ran the table, would finish with 93. And the Montreal Canadiens would be with 92. So it is there, but it is still very much the Rangers, even with this win, will not secure a playoff spot yet. They need another victory in one of their three remaining games. They are on Long Island on Tuesday. They host Montreal here on Thursday. As a save made by Lundqvist, and out come the Rangers again. The Rangers finish their season at Pittsburgh next Saturday. 6-2 New York with 9:04 to play in the period. White circles the goal and brings it out. A pass ahead for Tucker. On the wing it goes to Wellwood. He's unable to get around defenseman Merrick Malik. It's kept in momentarily. Volleyball to Tucker. A shot in front. And Wellwood couldn't redirect. Tries to come back out. And Tucker is knocked down. And down in a heap goes Blair Betts as well. Gill back to the goal. Wellwood holding the puck. Wellwood off on the wing. Tucker had it bounce right over his stick. And he gets nailed on a Hal Gill shot. Betts trying to get it out. Tucker took him down, and it's cleared out and down the ice by New York. An icing charge coming against the Rangers, who are leading 6-2. And you're watching Waltz of Canadian Leafs Hockey on TSN.
The New York Rangers, they do their video preparation. Jerry Dineen from the great Dineen family does their prep. Now, they really figure this one out. Look at Wellwood behind the net. Nobody is going to go to him because they know he won't take it to the net, rarely shoots. He's got offensive imagination, and he's looking to pass. So what they do is they take away his options. Don't chase him because you know you're just going to be on the wrong side of that chase. And it's Malik and Roosevelt with the two bookends on either side of the post, and they're the shutdown pair.
They're out against Sundin, Ponikarovsky and Anthropov with a 6-2 cushion to work with. The draw is won by the Leafs, but it is poked out past Coverley, and he'll have to go back to the center ice area for it. Change is coming as heading to the bench with Blair Betts after taking the draw. Drive by Anthropov is blocked, and Malik doubled over a little bit after blocking that shot. And Jágr tries to work it out and does. Nylander backhanded deep into the Toronto zone. Anthropov and Jágr in against the inboards. McCabe lays it back of the net, but it's cut off. Here's a chance in front of the net. They score. Jágr set up by Brad Isbister.
Well, the Leafs' defensive zone coverage has really been abysmal tonight, and that's been one of their strengths in the last little while. The fight starts between Anthropov and Jágr. Once you've gone to Jágr in the offensive zone, don't leave him, because he's going to head for a scoring area. And that's exactly what happens. And all alone.
93rd point of the year is in the books. That is 29th goal. And the New York Rangers are putting an exclamation point on this win against the Leafs. That will even the season series between the two as Lundqvist makes a save there off stage and in front of the goal. Jágr from his mister.
He leads the team in points. Tied for, or leads the team in goals now, assists, shots on goal, power play points. And here he's, in the last 2 years in New York, take a look at those stats. This guy's as good as he feels like being.
And that is oft times the problem.
Well.
But when he is going great.
New York team's going to be a tough one to handle, and if they make the playoffs, and it looks like they got a chance to do that.
Yes, they do. Kabina around back of the net. Devereaux gets it freed up. Stajan and knocked down his man, and out comes the Leafs with a pass on the right side for Steen. His drive went off the blocking glove of Lundqvist into the screening and out of play.
Jaromír Jágr, everyone thinks he's a non-talkative sort. It's exactly the opposite. There he's talking to Perry Byrne saying, do you have an idea? You've got to make sure that you know what, and of course, because of that, Rennie comes down. Do we have a problem here, Mr. Superstar? Because if we do, I'm going to correct it right now.
But that just shows you, when Jágr wants to play, he's got the passion, it really makes a difference because everybody has to be accountable.
Well, the Rangers are playing without two pretty good defensemen, Fedor Tootin and Karol Vakunic. He will knock two of these guys out of the lineup. And he's digging.
Paul tries to center, but the net has become dislodged as one of the Ranger defensemen crashed into goaltender Lundqvist in the race for that icing, and it will be faced off in the circle to the right.
Well, Lundqvist has been not the Leafs that are doing it this time. It's the Rangers.
Well, you want the playoff hopes to dash before your eyes if you're a New York Ranger fan or player. If this kid goes down, then they are in big trouble. They don't have a backup goaltender.
Steven Valiquette is the name you were thinking of,
you,
and
sir.
He is 1-2-0 with a 3.13 goals against average. There he is.
Now, you're right. You guys made a good point. If the Rangers stay healthy, they can do some damage in the postseason. You think about last year in the postseason, Jágr had the shoulder injury. And the team really didn't face any adversity until they got into the first round. Well, they've had their adversity early on in the year, and they're healthy, and they're getting great goaltending. I wouldn't want to face them in the East.
Well, depending on how New Jersey and Pittsburgh finish, at this particular point anyway, with the Penguins with 101 points, one more than New Jersey, it would be a Pittsburgh-New York first-round matchup.
12-3-3, counting this one, in their last 18 games.
And if the New Jersey Devils are able to overhaul the Pittsburgh Penguins and win their division, then it would be a Ranger-New Jersey series.
Not much rivalry there.
No, hardly at all. And I'm sure Lou Lamoriello is anxious so that it's only a bus ride.
Now, every one of these fans, they take great joy in knowing they don't live in the swamp. Uh-huh. And when they had a parade, they didn't have it in the parking lot. Okay, they had it on a real road.
Uh-huh.
Yes. Broadway.
However, the Devils fans could kind of point to a few more times that they've had a parade in the swamp.
It's funny. The Islanders as well. You know, the four Stanley Cups, the dynasty, and yet the Rangers get all the credit.
Exactly. Well, they have the Big Apple and Broadway to parade down in the Canyon of Heroes. Is that not what it's called, Heels?
Yeah, we'll call it that for sure.
And along the boards here is Pohl, unable to get to it. Centering effort was blocked, and the Rangers get it out. Slipped down into the zone. Around back of the net. With 5:26 left to play. And the Leafs, at this particular point, are obviously just hoping to get out of here with some help. And then realize that the final three games, they do have their destiny in their own hands if they are able to win. Or at least stay on pace with Montreal. The Canadians are at home to Boston Tuesday, here in New York against the Rangers on Thursday, and in Toronto on Saturday. The Leafs will host the Flyers on Tuesday, play the Islanders on Long Island on Thursday, and finish with the Canadians at home. A pass back into the slot. Ponikarovsky fanned on it. Nylander and Jágr on a 2-on-1. Ponikarovsky trying to get back, and the deflection on the poke check by Aubin. At the point, a shot is deflected, and Aubin stopped that. Ranger fans are enjoying this one, as well they should. Tucker lays it off on the left wing side. Hal Gill gets it to the line and in, and it is smothered by Lundqvist and Hell. The Rangers in a laugher, 7-2. Well, we're back here at the New York, and stay tuned after the game. TSN Next will continue coverage of the 2007 Ford World Men's Curling Championship as Canada takes on Switzerland. Glenn Howard and the Canadian team currently 2-0. Face off to the right of Henrik Lundqvist. 4:15 to play in the third period. Devereaux sending it back. Matt Sundin is getting the rest of the night off as Straka brings it out. And McCabe will settle it down and take it back into the Toronto zone. Ian White got it ahead, and it's deflected deep into Pittsburgh, into New York territory. Around on the boards it goes. Cut off there by Devereaux, played in along the wall for Steen. Steen battles his man for the puck and comes up with it. Tries to send it back for Stajan. They cycle it along the boards and then lost it. And the Rangers will get it to center, and Sean Avery sends it deep into the Toronto end. He is going to be the first star in the game, I do believe. As Avery with two goals and one assist. And now the New York fans are serenading the Leafs. Side is Jed Orkmeyer with a shot kicked away by Aubin. Callahan in along the boards, trying to get away from Ian White. Spun back in along. It comes out in front off the pass of Orkmeyer. Callahan leaves it there for Cullen. Cullen back to the point. Long shot wide of the Leaf goal. Came around on the far side. And up on the right side now for Gates Battaglia. Vocal group in this building, and always have been.
Well, there was a game earlier on this year, Joe. Rangers weren't playing well, and the crowd started chanting, "We suck."
So, yeah, they can be both the pro and con, can't they?
They wear their hearts on their sleeve.
Yep. Laid down into the zone and knocked out on the right side. Here's Blair Betts gaining center and into the Leaf zone. It goes. That bounced away off one of those stanchions, and Aubin had to watch it carefully. Kavina for Tucker. His pass off a skate and down into New York territory. The Rangers are closing in on the postseason here in New York. As it's set in wide of the goal. Tucker on the near wing. Trying to get it out. Tom Rennie has done an excellent job with this New York team. And in getting number 68 focused and ready to go is probably as big a compliment to him as any. Malik drops it back. Under 2 minutes to play. Nylander in on the right side. He'll play it back to Malik. Malik will send a wrist shot that is deflected by Isbister down and wide of the net. The Leafs will fly home, have a day to think about it, and then face the daunting task of trying to run the table or at least stay with the Montreal Canadiens until the big game next Saturday. And all the while hoping that Carolina doesn't get into the mix, as they have 86 points after their win today over Florida. Across the line with less than a minute to go, and the Ranger faithful are on their feet. Gill for Cole gets it back again. A long shoot in his block, and it's shot into the Ranger bench and out of play. The Ranger crowd enjoying it here. 7-2 New York. Jaromir Jagr with a goal and two helpers. Sean Avery with two goals and one assist. Gill will play it off to Brian McCabe. A lead pass, trying to sweep in there is Perreault. Played it around back of the net. Centering attempt went astray. Hole trying to dig it out. And the Rangers will get it out. Sean Avery. Tied up by Bates Battaglia. Here's Shanahan for Nylander. Back to the point. Avery looking for three, and he shot it wide. Cleared out into the center ice, and that'll do. The New York Rangers are within a win of a postseason berth. Tonight's game story is brought to you by Boston Pizza. Make Boston Pizza your Wednesday night hockey headquarters. You're among friends at Boston Pizza. Sean Avery with two goals and an assist. Andrew Raycroft driven from the net after four goals as the Rangers win it 7-2.
Well, the Leafs were soundly defeated by a much better team tonight here in New York.
Henrik Lundqvist does a great job, and the Ranger tradition that has started here, a salute to the crowd, will come here. Tonight's third period summary brought to you by Mazda, where it all comes back to Zoom Zoom. After a 5-2 lead, Roosevelt and Jagr complete the scoring in the third as the Leafs lose it by a score of 7-2. Our Molson Canadian three stars for this evening's game. Sean Avery, number one, Jaromir Jagr, number two, and Michael Nylander is the game's third star.
Well, the Leafs gave it a bit of a shot here for the first half of the first period, and then it was all Rangers.
7-2, the final. Avery with two goals and an assist, and this fight with Darcy Tucker. We invite you to stay tuned here on TSN as the Ford World Curling Championships are coming up next. For Harry Neal.